Hey everyone, in this video we're going to look at Microsoft stock. We're going to look at their financial statements, try and figure out an intrinsic value, and see whether it's worth buying today. If you're new to the channel, my name is Dan. I do a lot of stock analysis on this channel. So if you're into that kind of thing, hit that subscribe button to check out more videos like this one. With that out of the way, let's get into it. So here is Microsoft's three major segments. First, you got productivity and business processes. That includes things like Office 365, Skype, LinkedIn, Outlook, and OneDrive. Then you've got Intelligent Cloud there in the red. That includes things like Azure, GitHub, SQL Server, and Windows Server. And finally, you've got More Personal Computing over there in the green. That's where we have Windows. Also Xbox, the Surface, and other PC accessories. So they're pretty well split between the three segments. As far as the geography of their revenues, it's pretty split between US and other. They don't really break it down among the other countries. They only state that no other country accounts for more than 10% of their total revenue. So they have some diversification going on as far as currency risk, and I like to see that. So here are some fun facts about Microsoft's balance sheet that should help us assess the liquidity and solvency of the company. They have a liabilities-to-assets ratio of about 59%. That's pretty healthy. Their current ratio and quick ratio are both above, pretty much above 2.5. That's very healthy there, guys. So the current ratio of 2.53 means that our current asset over 2.5 times what our current liabilities are. We can easily pay off those current liabilities. Interest coverage ratio is about 22. That's just very healthy. So the money we earn every year can cover our interest expense 22 times. We have a big pile of cash on the balance sheet. I have noticed this with a lot of the big tech companies. If you saw my Google or Facebook reviews, 45% of our assets are just cash. We don't have hardly any inventory. And then their long-term assets account for about 41% of their total assets. So not too long-term asset intensive. So what's going on with that huge pile of cash on the balance sheet for Microsoft? Well, if we look at their cash tax rate, we may find some clues. The corporate tax rate has been 35% for most of this time, only being lowered to 21% in the year 2017. Despite that, Microsoft typically actually pays anywhere from 2 to 10% in taxes every year. So guys, what's going on here is that you have a situation where a lot of the profits Microsoft earns overseas are not being repatriated. Microsoft is not bringing those profits back here. Now, why are they doing this? Well, corporations don't have to pay taxes on profits they earn overseas until they bring them back over here. So essentially, Microsoft is just waiting around, hoping that maybe Congress will pass a tax holiday like they did in the year 2004. And we saw a tremendous amount of money come back to the US during that time. Will that happen? I don't know. But we have to kind of discount the cash on Microsoft's balance sheet. We have to kind of make the assumption that a dollar's worth of cash on their balance sheet isn't really worth quite a dollar. We're going to have to probably pay taxes on that. So what we have here is the DuPont analysis. You can check out my video on that in the description. But essentially, we're taking the return on equity, or ROE, very important measure of profitability for a company, and we're breaking it down into its three components. Now, why is ROE so important? Well, you're an equity investor. Whatever money we as equity investors put into the stock, that is our investment base. So given that amount of money we put in, what are we getting back? What's our return on that in terms of company profit? So Microsoft has a pretty sick ROE here. We're looking at anywhere from 35, 40, 47% there in 2019, doing very well. Net income margin is one way they do this. That tells you for every dollar of sales, how much in profits do they generate? And their net income margin is very healthy, coming in at about 32.3% in the most recent period. So for every dollar of sales, we bank 32 cents. That's very good. Asset turnover is once again very low, 0.49. Pretty stable though, so don't expect that to go up or anything. One thing to keep in mind is the asset turnover is really being dragged down by that big cash pile on the balance sheet. And then they have an equity multiplier, which is not too dramatic. You know, they're not extremely leveraged or anything. So overall, I love it. I love their ROE. And in fact, if you take out the cash, the return on equity would be even higher because their asset turnover would be even better. Here is the money they've spent paying stockholders dividends and also buying their own shares back over the past 5 years. And so these are in millions of dollars, by the way. Dividends, you've got a nice steady increasing dividend there in blue. And the share buybacks have been going up. And I love to see that. So Microsoft can very, very much afford to continue raising that dividend when you look at their payout ratio in the blue bars here. So look, in the past couple of years, their payout ratio is about 5%, meaning the dividend they give you is only 5% of their profits for the year. Can they afford to continue buying their shares back? Well, heck yeah, look at the green there. Your modified payout ratio tells you, okay, you got your dividends plus all the money to buy shares back. What percentage of net income is spent on that? And we're only spending about, you know, 13 to 15% of the money we make every year on buybacks and dividends combined. So Microsoft really is hoarding a lot of cash. I see them with, you know, with some reinvestments, but overall they're really being a cash hoarder right now. Okay, so before I try to value this company, I want to try and get a sense of how much they've been growing by. 15 years ago, I would have told you they're a mature company. They're not going to be growing much. And I wouldn't have been wrong. They really were flatlining there for a while. But look what's happened recently. They've had just tremendous growth in net income over the past 3 or 4 years or so. I would also say that Microsoft has a pretty wide moat on a lot of their products and services. You can see a wide moat when you look at things like margins. Here's their gross margin, extremely high, averaging at around 66 or 69%. And their operating margins are extremely high as well, getting up to about 38% in the most recent period. So I don't see a decline in margins right now. What I see is a company that is still able to dictate its prices pretty well. Okay, so after looking at everything, I absolutely love this company. They're doing excellent. But the question is really, is the price they're selling at a good deal right now? That's ultimately all we care about as investors. To get to the bottom of that, I need to do an intrinsic valuation using a discounted cash flow model. I'm going to be using the free cash flow to equity model to help value the company. To make the model work, I just need to make some assumptions. So whatever values I come up with, it all depends on those assumptions I'm going to make. And I'm going to show you guys how the value would differ if your assumptions change a little bit. So even if you think my assumptions are wrong, you can plug in your own and kind of see what the value would be. One of the most important assumptions is going to be that discount rate. We're going to look at the future cash flows and discount them back to present value. However much we discount them by should be a reflection of the risks the company faces. I think Microsoft is a pretty safe company. I can go with a lower discount rate, as low as 6%, really. I think that would be fine for Microsoft, but probably no more than 7. The second biggest assumption I'm going to have to make is how long can they keep growing and what can they grow by? So with a market capitalization of $1.68 trillion, there are some limits to growth. With that being said, they have managed to grow. If you look at their charts of their earnings, the most recent forecast data I have available estimates about a 12.2% growth rate in earnings per share over the next 3 to 5 year period. I'm going to go with that growth rate. I'm going to show you how that would differ with higher or lower growth rates though. And we're going to say that they're not going to be able to grow much after about 5 years. At that point, they're going to continue to grow by, we can say 1% or 2%. And, you know, we'll just go with 1.5. And that's going to be what they'll grow at that point. That's just the maturity phase of a business. So if I put all that together, what's going to be the value of the company? Well, let's have a look. Okay, so what I've put up here is a valuation matrix. And this each cell is going to show you what is the fair price for a share of Microsoft stock under two conditions. One is the discount rate there on the vertical, and the other is the free cash flow to equity growth rate on the horizontal here. So for example, if we assume a 12% growth in free cash flow to equity over the next 5 years, which is what our analysts are currently forecasting, and you want to use a 6% discount rate, then Microsoft would be worth $234.83 per share. I think this sell right here is probably the most likely. Now, unfortunately, Microsoft is selling for $222.75 at the time I make this video, making it not very much of a discount. But if you have different assumptions, if you believe Microsoft can grow at a much higher rate, for example, this is the most optimistic scenario we have, is a very low discount rate and a very high growth rate, yeah, it could be worth as much as $370. So another way of looking at this whole matrix is to say the following. Okay, I want a 7% return on my investment. I think Microsoft will grow at 14%. So I need to be paying no more than the value in this cell right here, $207.35. So collectively, when we look at it, check out the matrix below here. If it's a good deal, I put it in green, bad deal, red. It's pretty mixed. And I do think 5% discount rate is a little bit low. So for me, I don't think it looks like a good deal. One last factor that to look at is the insider activity. So for Microsoft in the past 3 months, you got 7 insiders buying and 7 selling. If you look at the number of shares involved, you've got about 101,000 shares bought compared to 340,000 shares sold. Overall, a slightly negative signal about the future of the company in the near term. Okay, so here are my final thoughts on Microsoft. It's going to be one of those stocks that I'm going to keep an eye on. After doing the analysis, I love their business. Extremely stable, high profit margins, indicating a great moat for a lot of their products. However, I can't see it being a buy right now. When you plug in the assumptions based on analyst forecasts and you just look at the matrix, there's really not that many scenarios where it turns out to be a good deal. I'm also a little bit skeptical about analysts forecasting this company growing at 12% for the next 5 years. Their market cap is already close to $2 trillion. At that point, you know, I have to ask, I mean, how much more can they grow? And so, you know, for now, I'm going to pass on it, but I will keep an eye on it. If the price went down all the way down to, say, $200 a share, I think I would jump on that. I would for sure buy Microsoft if it ever hit $200 a share. Anyhow, those are just my thoughts. Let me know in the comments below how you feel about Microsoft. And hit that like button, it helps me a lot.